Hi YouTubers, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me once again. Today is August 23rd, 2022. There has been 14 earthquakes that USGS has reported within the last 24 hours there at the Yellowstone National Park, or the Yellowstone Super Volcano. It's now up to 15. The majority of the earthquakes have been by Hedgen Lake and the Madison River area. You can see that here. The depth of the earthquakes have been varying from 6.7 miles below sea level to 1.9 miles below sea level. This is kind of like the outside rim of the caldera, where this would be along within the caldera, and that's probably why they're shallower. So we got one here down there at the Madison River Plateau. Let's see what else we got. Trying to look for the shallower ones. Again, 2.6 miles Mammoth or Madison River. They call it the Mammoth area. Another one, yeah, shallow, 2.4 miles. Now that one's shallow, 1.3 miles. That's unusual. They're saying it's a minus 0.4. There is a lot of earthquakes that they are not reporting. So during the last major eruption, the unzipping occurred starting up here by the Madison River area, and we had multiple smaller eruptions until it got down here by Heart Lake. And then the two resurgent domes, Yellowstone has two resurgent domes where the ground is rising. Most volcanoes only have one. And at that time, both resurgent domes collapsed at the same time, creating the last super eruption. As I already stated, there's been 40 smaller eruptions since the last major eruption. I downloaded data from three different monitors. Here we got Soda Butte, and that's only because it's been showing signs of screaming. A Little West Thumb, I couldn't get that data to download. Here we have the borehole. That's up by the Madison River area. This is the borehole for the Madison River area. And we got Maple Creek, and you can see all the ones marked in red. There's more than 15. Here on the stream view, this is what it's currently showing. The bottom is Soda Butte. The middle one here, Maple Creek. And at the top, we have Madison River. And you notice we got one quake right here. Well, there's other ones. We got some smaller ones. Two smaller ones within 2.5 hours. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Within 2.5 hours. Most recently for the screaming. Now, what do I mean by the screaming of a volcano? It, of course, would depend on how long it was making this noise. You can do a Google search on wired.com. They have an article about this. It says that the earth began to scream. Now, they realized back in 2009 from Redoubt Volcano there in Alaska that it was making noises, a different type of noise, before it erupted. Volcanic eruptions are usually preceded by an increase in earthquake activity. Published in Nature Geoscience describes how special harmonic microquakes may result from small, highly energized faults scraping like fingernails on a chalkboard. Some describe it as a tea kettle whistle. A similarly ordered pattern of tremors, neatly spaced like the teeth of a comb, have been seen before in the drumbeat earthquakes accompanied by the minor eruption of Mount St. Helens between 2004 and 2006. Here's an example of the comb of a teeth, what they call drum beats, right through here, And right through here. And let me pull it over. Through there. According to Durham, who was doing some research about these, what they thought at that time was unusual signatures, he said that fault pressure builds up more than 100 times higher than the atmospheric pressure in a blink of an eye. The repeating pops are probably caused by friction as the viscous magma slips past the rock around it, the molten fingernails on the rocky chalkboard, eventually in the moments just before the volcano explodes. The friction gives way to gliding, an instant calm before the storm. Well, it gets so loud that the machinery can't pick it up. The Smithsonian magazine had an article about volcano screaming. It turns out there are some volcanoes that actually do scream, emitting a tea kettle like screech prior to an eruption. The thick magma sticks to the rock surface inside the conduit until the pressure is enough to move it higher, where it sticks until the pressure moves it again. Essentially, each time the magma moves, it creates a small earthquake. By the time the volcano is ready to explode, the quakes are happening so quickly they become one sound. So at about 10:37 a.m. today, here we have Soda Butte, and this is what happened. Let me show you the seismic signature. See that? At 10:51 a.m., we got another one right there. This is the most recent from when I pulled the files. You can see it down here. You notice, too, right here, these are all rounded tops. This is what's called either harmonic or volcanic tremors. This was put out by USGS. We got tectonic. See, they got the sharpened points. Shallow volcanic earthquakes, long with rounded tops, a surface event. And then we got harmonic tremors. They're smaller than the volcanic tremors, but they both indicate that magma is on the move and it's recharging for another eruption. Yellowstone has been recharging for about 6,000 years, slowly growing. All right, so I'm just going to jump around here. Yeah, I got my grandkids, two of my grandkids. Yeah, look at that. And we'll just look at some of these smaller earthquakes because that's probably where they're at. Yeah, see how it went silent there? Yep. Another one. And another one. And another one. See how we had the earthquake and then it went quiet just like that other article showed, in another one, and they're all in red. Yeah, look at that. Let's look at some of the smaller ones and we'll pull it over and see what we got here. Again, this is Soda Butte. I started watching Yellowstone probably about 10 years ago. See, there's another one after El Ural went off. And let's pull this up. It had never shown activity like this until, maybe a month ago, I want to say, maybe a little bit longer. 1512 universal times, the last earthquake they are reporting. 1551, this one they're not reporting, comes in as a magnitude 2.73, and it was deep. You can see here in the hot gases that it brought up. There was another one right there marked in red. 1454. Did I say this was 15? Yeah, 1451. Okay, and this one here at 1454, that comes in as a magnitude 2.81. All right, let's see this one here, 1512. That one they are reporting. They're saying it's a magnitude 0.3 up by Hedge and Lake right there. And I really shortened up the seismic signature. Yeah, magnitude 1.72. All right, the next one marked in red would be this one right here at 14:31. Again, by Hedge and Lake, they're saying it's a 0.1. I don't know who's reading the monitors there at USBS. Oh, I'm sorry, USGS. But it's a magnitude 1.61. Look at them all. This is for Maple Creek. And yeah, see, there's those earthquakes that they talk about. Being the comb, the teeth of a comb. And someone was asking, what is blobs of magma? Now, a blob of magma, because, you know, magma's kind of thick and oozy. Just like what the name suggests. It's a blob, a thick, oozing blob, kind of like gelatin of magma that's coming into the system. Yeah, see that there? Think of goo. That would probably be a good... But here we got the goo, the blobs of magma. You can see they got the thickening of the lines. And, yeah, we got the combs of the teeth, which are actually drum beats. So you can do a Google search. Magma is molten rock beneath the Earth's surface that can cool into rock. Blobs of molten magma can rise through the crust. If a blob of magma, yeah, you think they would come up with something better than blob. If a blob of magma gets stuck in the crust, it cools slowly into rock. In the past, blobs of magma got stuck in the crust and cooled slowly into the granite of the High Sierra. And then you can come down here. It says here, what are mantle blobs? The mantle blobs are properly known as long, low shear wave velocity provinces, or LLSVP. This means when seismic waves generated by an earthquake travels through these deep mantle plumes, the waves slow down. So along the Firehole River, there was at one time a dike intrusion, a crack in the ground, that built up a dam of magma that cooled. And I have noticed, and they know that this dike intrusion prevents the heat, the heated water, etc., from the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome to move down and across. Back in 2018 and 2019, that's why most of the increase in activity for Yellowstone was on the northern side of the Firehole River. And I noticed today too that on the northern side of the Firehole River, the steam coming from a lot of the geysers was dirty. I took some screen captures. You can see here some of the different geysers and see the the gray looking steam. Here's another screen capture I took this morning. Now, this is caused by the heated water melting the rock, and the rock that's melted is carried up by the steam. This is what it's currently showing. I wish they would zoom in, but it's iron sulfide, and that melts at 2,181 degrees Fahrenheit. It produces hydrogen sulfide gas. It's known as sewer gas, swamp gas, stink damp, or sour damp. It's colorless gas known for its pungent, rotten egg smell. But we can only see it because of the rock particles that don't melt that rise up with the steam. They're currently looking at beehive. So that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Please stay safe. Keep prepping. Don't ever stop prepping. There's always something extra to add to the prepper supplies. Thank you for taking your time to watch. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.